I'm going to provide an overview of the updated grommet feature in Smart Designer Pro 2021. The most important thing when using the grommet feature is getting your page size set up. So the grommet feature works off of page size. It does not work off the size of the actual banner. So the banner size and the page size need to match. So I'm going to set up a banner that is going to be 60 by 36. Changing that up on the Corel property bar. I'm using a portrait or landscape orientation, in this case landscape. My unit of measurement is inches. So here's my blank page, and I'm going to actually design onto that page. In this case, I'm actually going to use a stock banner template from our Banner Studio. So I'm going to go over here and click on Access Graphics Browser. I can go through the different banner layouts until I find the one I'm interested in. I'm going to select this one right here, which is the same dimensions as the graphic I'm choosing, which is 60 by 36. Very important to select size to page when you double click on the banner template. So we're going to double click on that banner template. It's going to bring it in. It's got set up a little bit with margins there. So if I want to increase that product right there, just maybe make 36 and we get it right up on our page there. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to edit my text. So I'm going to come over here, I'm going to edit my text. This is in the templates feature in Smart Designer. If we want to change this to, say, state, champions, maybe you want to change the clip art out, recolor it, you can do all that. I'm just going to change this to 20, 21, just some basic changes. So the reason that we would add grommets to this is that if this is printed digitally, what we would want to do is add the grommets, but we want to put a location or a target where the grommet is going to be added. And so by actually printing the grommet onto the banner, that supplies the target. So when we actually apply the grommet, we know exactly where to put it. It also could be used for a virtual sample purposes, but the main purpose of the grommet feature is to place a target where you're going to apply the physical grommet. So the way we're going to do that is we're going to come down here to printing and cutting in the Smart Designer software, and we are going to go down here to the place grommet feature. So the place grommet feature, the way it works, we set up the number of grommets across. In this case, I've set up 3 across. I've set up 2 down. I can either use an outside offset or, more typically, an inside margin. So my inside margin, I have this set up for a 1-inch margin. So it's going to inset from the boundary of the actual banner 1 inch. Also, you have additional settings down here. So if we click on the little cog here, we can go to the additional settings. Here's the diameter of my grommet. In this particular case, we have the width of the outline. If we're using one of these targets, which is vector-based, we can specify the width, make it thicker or thinner. Remove grommets, what we'll do is we'll replace, if we change settings, it will replace the previous grommet. It just removes them and adds the new location. So if we were going to do some tweaking to this, it would remove the previous grommets if we add a new set. And then lock page, what that's doing is it's fixing the page size. So this page size would be fixed. There is no way to alter it. In that case, it would be locked to 60 by 36. So we don't want to lock the page. We want to use the page in the actual CorelDRAW document. So once we have our settings set up here, we want to add the grommet. All I have to do is just click on it, and it's automatically applied it. If I wanted to go in and change the settings, for instance, maybe make that 0.5, I could go and do that. Maybe pick a different target. It's going to replace that. And in some instances, it might be beneficial to put the target outside of the actual banner. If you did that, you could specify it to be outside of the banner. So maybe there's a bleed area in the print. So we'll go and add a different target there as well. So the more typical usage would be something along the lines of this. There you go. So that's the grommet feature. Now, these can be moved. They're art objects, so they can be moved. They can be resized. But it's just a very simple automated feature. So the most important thing to remember is the grommets are placed based on the margin of the page size, not the actual graphic itself. They're all based off the page size. So it's very important to get your page size set up. It works just like a margin. So the margin is being determined by the page size, not the actual graphic itself. Hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. Play around with the grommet feature. It's a pretty clever little feature. It's quite useful for folks that are doing wide format digital printing and banners.